Welcome to PsycINFO, a quick introduction. PsycINFO is a database that specifically looks at the psychological literature, so if you have a psych question, it's a great place to start. Now, this database is by subscription only, so you must access it by going through the library's website. So go to medlib.bu.edu, hover over e-resources, select databases, select the letter P for PsycINFO, scroll down to it, click on it, and it will prompt you to log in with your BU username and password. Now let's suppose that the psych question you're interested in is PTSD and child abuse in women. This first page it brings you up to is the basic search. You would use this in a Google style, entering one type of term in each box. So I'm going to put in PTSD, child abuse, and women, and then I'm going to hit search. This brings back a good number of results, about 430. As you scroll through them, some of them seem really relevant, but as you keep looking, you can start to see that some not so relevant ones are coming up, such as this one about intimate partner violence, which is not the same thing as child abuse. What can happen is that since you're doing a natural language search, it splits up your terms and looks for them everywhere, in the title, in the abstract, in the subjects, everywhere. So sometimes articles come up that briefly mention your topic but aren't actually about it, and so it will bring those back. If you want to get narrower or more precise results, which sometimes isn't exactly the same as narrower, you might want to use the subject terms. Now each of these articles is tagged with the subject terms that it's about. Now these are from a list of specific terms that's called a thesaurus in this database that when these articles get entered in, they're tagged as being about these specific things. So you can see, for instance, that they call PTSD post-traumatic stress disorder, so that's the official term. If you search using these terms, instead of searching through the entire article and the entire abstract and everything, it looks only in the subjects for what it's about. So in order to get to that, you want to click on thesaurus, because we need to figure out what terms we're using. Obviously, we know now that post-traumatic stress disorder is the term for PTSD, but I want to show you that if you put in PTSD, if you put in the acronym, which acronyms are used a lot in psych, if you put in PTSD and hit enter, it will recognize it and tell you to use post-traumatic stress disorder. Now, I'm going to tell it, using these checkboxes, that I want only PTSD if it's a major concept. So if a subject is noted as being what this article is really about, that's called a major concept. So that will help further narrow your results to only specifically PTSD and child abuse for you. So now I'm going to hit add. And you can see that MM means that's a major concept. If I hadn't checked off that checkbox and had just put it in without that, it would come up as DE, and that would mean subject. And like I said again, that would come up as anything tagged as this being about that, which might not be a major concept. So now I have post-traumatic stress disorder in that box, and I need to also put in child abuse. So I'm going to search for that. And if you want more information about any of these terms, if you click on it, it will tell you the year the term was introduced, which is useful because then you will know if you're automatically limiting yourself to only within the last couple of years or something like that. It tells you their official definition of the term. It tells you a broader term in case your search is getting too narrow results. It will tell you a narrower term if there is one. And it will also tell you related terms. All of these things can help you think through your search and find the thing that's most useful for you. But for us, this is the term that we want. So I'm going to again select the checkbox on the left for the term, and on the right for that, it's a major concept. In this little drop-down menu here, I'm going to say I want to combine it with an and, because we want only articles that talk about PTSD and child abuse as both of them major concepts. This is what's going to really refine our results. I'm going to hit add, and now I'm going to hit search. You can see that we get back 492 results, which is a very similar number to the number we had before. It's actually a few more. But if you scroll down through them, you can see that these articles are a lot more relevant to our actual topic. Now, I know we haven't put on women yet. How are we going to put on women? We need to use the limits on the left-hand side. And there are more options than just women and age for limits, so I'm going to show them to you. One thing you can do over here is you can say, oh, I only want the full text, if the full text is easily linked. One thing that I really recommend doing is turning on publication dates to more recent. 1980s information probably won't be as useful to you, so I'm just going to go ahead and say I want within the last 10 years, so from 2003. And then you select update, and it will refine your results to within those last 10 years. You can see that cut out about half of the articles, so we're only getting back the more recent, more relevant articles. One of the nice things about PsycINFO is that it brings back more than just articles. It also brings back dissertations, books, and reviews. So you can also limit by that type of source type to just say dissertations if that's what you were interested in. You can also narrow by publication, so say that you know you really like the articles in child abuse and neglect, you could only look at that. This subject major heading, this pulls back the most popular major headings for the articles. So for instance, if you're seeing a lot of sexual abuse, maybe you decide you want to refine your research topic to women who suffer sexual abuse in childhood, you could do that. You could also say maybe become interested in, well, this therapy gets mentioned a lot, so maybe it's an important therapy for this type of mental illness. Subject is the same thing, it's just the broader, it includes all of the subjects, not just the major headings. Age is one that we want to turn on. This can get a little bit complicated because there are a lot of categories for age. It's not just child and adult. You can see there's adulthood, which is 18 years and older. There's young adulthood, etc., etc. So you really want to read the definition next to it. What we want is adulthood, which is 18 years and older. But again, you could maybe decide that you're only interested in young adults. So you could maybe decide later you want to turn that on. But for right now, you want to check the checkbox next to adulthood and select update. That brings us down to 160 articles, but we still haven't turned on the gender of women. So here under gender, you want to turn on female. And it's nice that it tells you right next to it how many articles that's going to bring back for you. So we know that we're going to have 140. It's also interesting to note that there's more articles about women in child abuse and PTSD than men. It's just interesting to see how the limits tell you these things as you go through. So now we're down to 140 really relevant results. And the last two limiters that you could use, one is classification, so how it's classified in psychological terms, so you could maybe narrow to just prevention if you were interested in that. And there's also methodology, so maybe you only want to read articles where they interviewed somebody, or only clinical case studies, you could narrow further that way. Now once you have your searches, maybe you get a little bit lost. Maybe you decide, oh, I want to go back to something I had earlier. You don't have to retype it all in. Up here underneath the search boxes, there's a link to search history. This will show you all the searches you've done in this session in PsycINFO. If you want to be able to save your search history, you would have to create an account in PsycINFO. And you can also combine previous searches together. So if you also had done a search for a different term, such as maybe the cognitive behavioral therapy, you could combine the searches by using these checkboxes next to them, and then say search with AND or search with OR, and it would run that search for you. You can also just easily go back and view previous results by clicking View Results, and also next to it tells you how many results will come up for that. Once you have your search that you really like, there are various things you can do with each item that comes up. If there is a full text easily available, it will link to it in either HTML or PDF, or it will have a link to it, or it might have a Find It View button. There are lots of different ways to get to the full text. You can add an item you like to your folder. So if you really like this, say Add to Folder. And your folder is linked up here, and if I click out to it, it will show me all the items I've saved in my folder, and I can select what ones I want, and I can print the references, or I can email them, or I can save it as a file, or I can export it. And those are all various ways that are good for saving what you found for writing papers later, or just reading your list later. I'm just going to go back to our search results. Another thing that links out to from our search results is the cited references. So if you wanted to see all of the items that this article cites, you can click cited references and view them. Which is nice because then you don't actually have to get the full text to see exactly what this article cites. And if you're interested to know what subject terms this article is tagged with, if you click on it, you can view the abstract, and you can also view what subject terms they're tagged with. The major terms have an asterisk next to them, and you can see that post-traumatic stress disorder and child abuse both have asterisks next to them. But this can help you maybe think of more terms that you might want to use. Again, sexual abuse came up, but physical abuse came up. Maybe you decide you're only interested in one or the other of those, so you could do that as well. There is a find similar results search, but I honestly find frequently that that becomes irrelevant very quickly, so I think it is more useful to look at the subject terms and look into combining them as you can. Thank you for watching A Quick Intro to PsycINFO. For more information about this or any other library resources or services, please feel free to contact the Reference Desk at 617-638-4228 or refquest@bu.edu.